child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders. And he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Of the greatness of his government and peace, there will be no end. He will reign on David's throne, over his kingdom, establishing and upholding it with justice and righteousness from that time on and forever. The seal of the Lord Almighty will accomplish this.
As we have prepared for the coming of Christ, each week we have lit a candle of the Advent wreath. We have lit candles as we have celebrated the wonder of Christmas. Tonight we light the Christ candle.
Is the center of Christmas, but also because he is the center of history, the center of God's work of redemption, and the center of our lives.
Hear again these words of Scripture concerning his birth. Therefore the Lord himself will give you a sign. Behold, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and shall call his name Emmanuel, which is translated God with us. But you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are not the least among the rulers of Judah. For out of you shall come a ruler, who will shepherd my people Israel, and they will live securely, for his greatness will reach to the ends of the earth, and he will be their peace.
While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn.
Tonight we celebrate the true wonder of Christmas, Jesus Christ.
God, would you stand now as you are able and let us join together in singing Joy to the World. the Lord this night as we welcome and celebrate the birth of the Savior Christ our Lord. Would you go with me now into prayer? Holy God, we love you and we praise you for this holy and precious night. We love you because you have first loved us and you have claimed us as sons and daughters of the Most High God. And we love you and we praise you because we know, God, that in the fullness of time, you created and sent your Son, born of a virgin, to redeem those of whom. And you have come, and we are here tonight, Lord, to celebrate and remember all that you are and all that you have done for us. For great is your love and great is your mercy upon us. Most holy God. God, I know that there are many in this room that we are celebrating tonight, and yet there are still those who are a part of our family circle who are not able to be with us tonight. We ask your blessings, God, on those tonight who are suffering, on those who need a healing touch, on those who grieve. And we ask that the joy of this night and this joy of this season be so great that it would overshadow anything that would come against us in Jesus' name. We pray for your joy to cover any sense of frustration. We pray for your joy to cover the sense of loss. We pray for your joy to cover our anxiety and our worries, God. And we come with joy before you tonight, because you are Lord, and you are worthy of our grace. We thank you for the holiness of this season, and for the holiness of this night that you have given to us to celebrate the birth of the Savior. Thank you, God, for this holy and precious night.
Let me invite all the children to come up now for our time together. Come on up!
Shook that tree and all that good.
We give gifts, oh so fun, from my friends at Christmas time. But God gave us so many gifts, you see, He gave these for you and me.
Yay! That's a wonderful song. Thank you for singing those songs for us. You guys did a great job. I think all of us should sing for Jesus tonight, don't you? So why don't we all sing Happy Birthday to Jesus. You ready? Help me sing Happy Birthday to Jesus, right? Happy Birthday to you. Happy Birthday to you. Happy Birthday, dear Jesus. Happy Birthday to you. Beautiful. Let's have our prayer. You repeat after me. Dear God, we love you so much, and our hearts are filled with joy because we celebrate Jesus' birthday. Thank you, God, for sending us your Son. We love you. Yay, God! Amen. All right, you guys can scooch to your seats now. Thank you. Very Merry Christmas. I'll see you tomorrow. See you later. Her mom and Sophie is going to teach us many things in this life and in this church. Her mom told her that this isn't really the date of Jesus' birthday, because we don't really know when that happened, but we're celebrating Jesus' birthday. Tonight, the birthday of the King is here, and it doesn't matter where you are, it doesn't matter who you're with, but what matters is that you celebrate and let God know that you love Him, that you appreciate what He's done in sending His Savior.
Spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child.
And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told. My brothers and sisters, this is the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
name that is above all names, and you are our blessed Redeemer, and you are our Lord, and we are your people. Thank you, God. Bless us now as we remember a piece of the story of how you have given yourself to us and how you continue to give yourself to us and for us. Thank you, God. Amen. All he really ever wanted to do was play the part of Joseph. His name was Billy, and his class at school was putting together their nativity pageant for the year. And as the parts were read, he was really hoping he was going to get cast as Joseph finally this year. He was finally tall enough to stand next to Mary and be taller than her. And so this year, he was hoping to be cast as Joseph. Well, when the parts were given out, the teacher called Billy's name, and Billy was to play the innkeeper. And his rival, Thomas, was given the part of Joseph. Well, he began to plot, Billy did, what he would do to get his revenge against Thomas, because he wanted to play Joseph and he didn't get the part. And he plotted at every practice he would go through his part just like he was supposed to. Sorry, there's no room. No room at the end. But that night, the night of the pageant, he had everything all set in his mind. And so that night in the pageant, as Joseph and Mary came to the door of the inn and they knocked on the door, he opened the door grumpily and said, "What do you want?" And Joseph said, "We'd like to have a room for the night, my wife and I." And he said, "Well, come on in. I'll give you the finest room in the house." It really stumped poor little Thomas there for a moment, but Thomas was always quick on his feet. And so after a moment, a dramatic pause, as they say in the theatrical world, Thomas looked inside the inn like this and he goes, "Are you kidding? No wife of mine is going to stay in a dump like this. Come on, Mary, we're going out to the stable." We've all heard this wonderful story over and over again. We've played parts in the pageants. We've sung the songs. We've read the scriptures. Oh my goodness, this year, I'm normally a stickler. Those of you who are visiting with us tonight, I am normally a stickler about Advent being a time where we build up the 4 Sundays before Christmas, that we really build up. This year, we did a program called The Wonder of Christmas, and we read Christmas texts, and we read little bits and pieces of the Christmas story, the Annunciation to Joseph, the Annunciation to Mary. We had a day where we celebrated the star and remembered the stories of the wise men and the shepherds. We had a day where we talked about the wonder of a manger. We had a day where we talked about the wonder of the name that was to be given to Jesus. We had a day where we talked about the wonder of a promise. And we talked about the fact this past Sunday that all of those things really led up to this amazing piece of our story. And it goes something like this. "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son." This week, I've had the privilege of visiting with 3 people who've really touched my heart in a special way. I think it was Wednesday that I got to go to the hospital and meet baby Tucker Wayne Chalkley for the very first time. I don't know when the last time was that you got to see a brand new baby, but don't ever miss an opportunity. I had a little bit of a cold, and so I wouldn't go near him before I couldn't take my eyes off him the whole time I was there. And I said, "Welcome to our world, baby Tucker." And I thought about his life, and I think about his life now, and I give thanks with him and his family that he is born into a family that will love him all of his days, and they will do everything that they can to make his life good. But Tucker's going to have some days where he's gonna run into some tough stuff. But right now, the joy of this brand new life is such a great joy for his family. It was a delight for me to meet sweet little Tucker. Today, I got a phone call from a young man named Jason. I met Jason when he was 4 years old and I became his pastor in Amelia. When I would do, he was a lot like this little guy who could take over the children's sermon in a heartbeat. And I would be telling these wonderful stories of Jesus, and he would raise his hand and I would say, "Yes, Jason." And he would say, "My grandma has that on video. I know that story." And it's been really cool to be able to watch Jason grow up. When I left Amelia and came here to be your pastor, Jason was 12 years old. Jason's 19 now. And so today he called and he's on leave from the Navy for 2 weeks for Christmas. And he came by to see us today. And it was a joy to listen to how God had blessed his life from the years that we got to watch him, from a four-year-old to now a 19-year-old man who is serving our country. My heart beats with joy when I think about his maturity and the way that he serves and the way that he lives. Couldn't help but ask the preacher a question. I mean, he told me all the things about what it was like to, you know, serve on a submarine, and he's working on missiles, and he told us all about that. And I said, "Well, you know, I have to ask, how are you living out your faith?" And he told us. He said, "I don't always get to church because the Protestant services only meet every other Sunday on base, but I try to get there as often as I can." Jason's grown into a very handsome and sweet and sincere and wonderful man. It was great to celebrate and hear his stories today. But there have been, and there will be, days where Jason struggles. Things will happen in his life where he'll need someone to be with him. But for today, we celebrate the joy of a visit with Jason. On Thursday, I got to visit with Mary Thornhill. Mary's one of the oldest members of this congregation. She's 84 years old, and she spent more days in the hospital this year than a lot of us combined together. She spent several weeks throughout the year, and nobody can really tell me exactly what's going on with Mary. I think she's just getting old, and her body is playing out. Mary's been over at Lucy Core now for 3 weeks, and she's getting therapy, but her body is weak, and she's tired. When I went in, I almost didn't recognize her, because you know our Mary Thornhill, those of you who are members of this church, and what joy her life brings just when she walks in the room, and she's feisty. By the way, she said to tell all her boyfriends, "I'm coming back." And she said, "Come visit me, and you better bring presents." Mary's had rough days in her life, but today I'm celebrating with joy the fact that I got to be with her for about an hour, and we got to share, and we got to pray together. You know, the Lord knows that from our days when we're just as young as little Tucker, and when we're just as old as our sweet Mary, the Lord knows that there are going to be days where we need some help. That's why we celebrate tonight the Savior that came into the world. God didn't have to come in skin and save us. Did it because he loves us. That night, while the shepherds were out in the fields watching their sheep, the angels came and they shone in the glory of the Lord around them, and they said, "We bring you good news, for to you is born a Savior." To you, who today things are looking really great for you. To you, who maybe tonight are a little stressed about, when is she going to stop preaching because our meal is going to be ready. To you, who are stressing, wondering if you remembered to blow out that candle. See, I've been worried now, didn't I? To you who are thinking about that special someone who won't be sitting at your table tonight. To you, a child is born. And we should sing great hallelujahs to his name. Because God so loved the world that he came to be among us. Jesus, Emmanuel, that's what it means. God is with us. And that's something to sing hallelujah about. Let us pray. God, we thank you and we praise you for this night. And we praise you for the opportunities that you've given us to be loved, to be encouraged, to have our feet held to the fire for accountability. And we praise you, God, for the days that have been difficult for us. But yet, at the same time, we praise you because even though it's hard to be alive sometimes, you have given us life and life abundant and life everlasting through your Son, Jesus Christ. And that is a reason to celebrate every single day. And so tonight, God, we join our hearts together with the angels. And we pray that in our life, in our celebrations, in our sharing of the love of Christ Jesus, that we will, in everything that we say and everything that we do, that we will join in singing the hallelujahs with the angels in celebration of Christ who was born for us. Thank you, God, for loving us in that way. Amen. After the supper, Jesus took the cup, and he blessed it, and he gave it to his disciples, and he said, "Drink from this, all of you, for this is my blood that is poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Drink from this, and every time you drink from this,
Remember.
And so tonight, we remember his story, because it's not just history, it's our story too. We remember his story, and we celebrate that Christ came for us. And we join the angels in singing hallelujah, and singing the holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty. We join together as brothers and sisters bound together in the love of Jesus Christ. Let us pray. Almighty God, for these gifts that you have given to us, for your Son, Jesus Christ, who came in such a humble way to live among us, and who grew and taught us and loved us and healed us, and then gave his life for us so that we could know life and life abundant and life everlasting. For these great gifts, God, we give you thanks. And we pray now that you would blow like a mighty wind through the power of your Holy Spirit among us. And that you would pour out upon us gathered in this place. And upon these gifts of bread and wine. That you would pour out your Spirit. And make these gifts for us. The body and the blood of Jesus Christ. Broken and poured out for us. And God, through the receiving of these gifts, may we be profoundly changed as we remember and as we celebrate once again this night the birth of the Savior, who came in such a humble fashion to save us from our sin. Forgive us, we pray, God, for those things that we have done against you. And through your Son, Jesus Christ, through these gifts of your salvation, bless us and make us sinless and holy, that we might know how you want us to live as sons and daughters of the Most High God, and that all that we say and all that we do henceforth will bring you honor and glory. Body of Christ. The cup of salvation. My dear brothers and sisters, these are the good gifts of God for us, the people of God. Together now, let us keep the feast. Amen. The people waited. And after a while, the people even said that God was silent. But on that night, in the midst of a dark and sinful world, the light of the world was born. I don't know what we would do. I don't know what people do without the light of Christ. And yet I know that there are a lot of people who are still walking in darkness because they haven't found the Savior yet. And so it's the job of each and every one of us as we celebrate the good news of his birth. It is the job of each and every one of us to pass on the light of Christ, so that those who have walked in darkness can see the great light of Christ Jesus, our Lord. It's amazing to watch just how one little light can become brighter and brighter. When the love of Christ Jesus is shared from one person to another person, from that person to yet another, than those who have walked in darkness began to see the difference that the light of Christ brings into the world. As you are able, would you stand and let us sing together the beloved Christmas hymn, Silent Night. Praise you. Amen. Merry Christmas.